Nope. All right, we're just gonna jam this. So, have you been playing this in competitive or friendly, or just does it matter? Your thoughts? Nah, we're just gonna go right to competitive. I don't really like it, but he says this deck is like amazing. So we'll see how true this is. Yeah, seems pretty solid. We're gonna rip their hand apart, remove their stuff, and then see if a Blood Moon can win it. Electro Dominance, Living in Business. Okay. I feel like taking the Ancestral here is key, because they can Dominance into it on turn two. So we're going to snag that and then pass it over. Pyromancer back, but if you do it now, I'll be forcing them to use a Living End on it, which seems worth it because they don't have much going on right now either. Alive, they have one creature. Seeing and as foretold. Nope, just passing it. All right. That's Faithless. If they want to dominance it. Yeah. Sure. We get a creature and some draws. Don't think. Okay, they're out. Dominance and Loving End. Don't think Blood Moon's going to be too relevant. I want the land. Brutality can rip another spell out of their hand, and Dreadbore is going to be needed to take out that Sphinx, so. Do it like that. Dreadbore that. And pass it over. Cryptic and Ash Foretold. I'm not really worried about the Ash Foretold. So I'm gonna take the. We're gonna rip the Cryptic out of their hand with this Collective Brutality. Dominance is just a fireball. They've burned through two Living Ends already. Okay, I'm gonna get rid of the Aspir Toll because Dominance will just be a one shot. So we'll just slam this hazard and start beating him. Right, they're gonna shoot that. Swing at us for four. Run out this hazard. Here. Drop this Reveler. Draw three cards. I see people, a lot of people play this deck now. It's great value. So I want to bring in the Rakdos Charm and the Spell Bombs. I'm not impressed with these Blood Moons in this matchup. Wouldn't even mind bringing in the Ensnaring Bridges and taking out the Kolaghan's Commands. I like where we're at with this, so I'm just going to play it. Not really interacting much. No hand hate. No graveyard hate. Pretty much just going to be relying on the Hazoret. Not a fan of this hand. I'm going to mull this. Unfortunately, we hit a no land hand. Alright, still no lands. Alright, we're going to keep this, even though we have no lands. It's four, it's got double spell bomb. We'll see if we're good enough to win. Land. Oh my gosh. I think my deck's punishing me. I was like, that hand was perfectly fine. Four lands, two interaction spells against them. Passing that over. If we get to untap, we've got a spell bomb, so obviously we'll win. Gonna click us. Spell bomb you. Spell bomb here. I want to be able to hold a black mana to draw a card because we're just not doing much. And they're going to have some Ancestrals going off. One this turn, one next turn. Drawing an infinite amount of cards. Thank you. Chalice of the Void on two, huh? Okay. Spell bomb. Let's inquisition them, see what they're working with. Double Living End and a Fairy Macabre. Let's get rid of a Living End. They get three more cards. Lyria West into another chalice. Suspend another ancestral. Living End, but I guess we could run out this Hazoret, try to start shooting them. And if they're Living End, then we're just not in a great spot. Going to chalice for one and two, their chalice on two. Cool story. Looks like we're just gonna pass here. And we're just gonna shoot them for two on their turn. If they go for the Living End, if they don't discard the Fairy Macabre, we can. Oh, there's some lines that are possible here, if, depending on how they sequence things. Which was hard casting Ceridon, okay. Discard Skulls and hit you. Sacred Foundry. cast our collective brutality to get countered, shocking ourselves, swing for 5, and then we can hold up Reveler. Here and they're gonna get 4 cards in this turn. Oh my gosh. Drawing so many cards compared to us. Just getting it out of the way. Sure. Sure. And then we are gonna discard this Bedlam Reveler. Some card value. Be anything else we should be worried about and get a prowess trigger. Another living end, an ancestral remain. We're good with just removing this ancestral. Leave them the living end and the remain. And then we can swing in. Ourselves lifelink. Boom. 1-0. This hand seems sweet. Necessarily care about anything. That's just gonna. It's 1/1s. This just makes things harder for us to cast. I guess we'll take the Tithe Taker this turn and then the Judith the following turn. No, we can just do that. Yeah. Because we're gonna want to go Pyromancer on our turn. So. Collective brutality. Blood Moon's not doing much for us here. All right, they got two turns to path. Otherwise, Judith could take over the game. Yeah, I'm gonna take the Judith here. Then just gonna be creatures. Oh, that's fair. So, like, if I... Yeah, okay. So here, we can just bolt the cut sail. Escalate. We're gonna give something -2/-2, and then take a spell out of their hand. Thank you. we're just gonna let them hit us. Don't want to bolt that, because I'm just gonna be able to keep going back. Bolting the Traveler gives us another creature. Then we can start swinging. We're gonna lose that race, though. Yeah, we're gonna bolt the Traveler. Is gonna get us back into this race. See what they're working with. Nothing. Easy peasy. Alright. Seems like they're a pretty aggressive deck, so I want to bring in these Timelies. And this Lovely seems like it's going to be really high quality against them. The Spell Bombs are less than sweet. And the Blood Moon seems to have pretty big significance against them. They are three colors and they're relying on their duels and their caverns a good bit. I think I like everything else. So maybe I'll just call one Blood Moon. Pretty solid group of removal here for us, and then looting. We'll make sure to grab a plains with one of these. I think we're just going to play this in the pass. So we're probably going to kill that champion here. Fine with it either way. I'm most likely just going to be Inquisitioning them. Oh, they're going to take her Inquisition. How dare they? It's fine. It's major effective. So we're going to have a Plains. And we'll escalate here. Oh my gosh, I was not supposed to get rid of that bloodstain. That was terrible. That was a big punt. Alright, we are rescued. Okay, Dreadbore, the Dauntless, try to save ourselves a little bit of life. Or we can Faithless here. I guess we can pass it back to them in Helix. Hold that up. Pass it over to them and we'll hold up Helix. Helix the Dauntless, we're not going to gain any life. In our hand and Faithless next turn, or just Faithless now. Yeah, we're gonna Faithless now. Let's see what else we can hit. Timely seems pretty good. So does Dreadbore. Blood Moon less so. So we'd be just, they'd still be having the red anyway. So we'll get a red Blood Moon and Godless here. We'll pass it over. Here, kill the aristocrat. They'll drop in the other one. Alternatively, we can Dreadbore the Thalia. Get rid of that. Thought sees them, get rid of the other Falcon Wrath, take another four, and then on the following turn we can collective and kill it, the Falcon Wrath. Because if we just kill the aristocrat right now, we're going to be taking four next turn anyway. So this way we remove two creatures. Thank you.
gosh.
Bringing in these bridges. This hand has Inquisition into nothing, which I don't think we can keep. Alright, we'll keep this. And Snaring Bridge on top. Kaito Kumball. We will take Kaito. Helix their kite sail in response. So I can't. I don't have the mana for it, so I'm just gonna play the Sacred Fire intact. Need to keep the land and keep one removal spell. We can either keep the Helix or the Druid Boar. If we keep the Helix, we cannot cast it this turn. We take the Druid Boar, we can. They have a Falcon Wrath, a Cliff Top, and a Cabal in hand. I feel like we need to keep the Bedlam Reveler because that's how we're going to draw back into this game. So let's get rid of the Inquisition and the Lightning Helix so we can cast the Dreadboar this turn. We do have a couple double black spell. It's the only one, but yeah, we're gonna grab a Plains here just in case we draw that. No, we need to grab the Red Source. Yeah, so we're gonna shock ourselves with a Blood Crypt, and then we're gonna Dreadbore this Kite Sail. Pass it over to them, and we'll plan on. If they go Kumball, I mean, no matter what, we're probably going to be dropping the Snaring Bridge. Yeah. It's unfortunate because I'd love to cast this Collective Brutality, but it's just not that great right now. The unfortunate side of the Snaring Bridge is if when we cast it, we're not gonna prevent any damage from it. Because of the Kambala's being at 2 and we have 2 cards in hand. Back to our turn, we can start winning. Ideally, they swing with the Kambala to try to get us down to 2. Go down to 4, but we'll be down, then nothing should be able to swing, and then we can start whittling away their board. So the Kambala and then plus it. Alt, start getting a slew of creatures. Seems cool. And I think we'll hold the card in hand because we can always throw it out there And I'd like to be able to swing with the 2/2s. Swing this turn. That's okay. We'll hold it up and swing next turn and give everything a lifelink as well. So I kind of stumbled through that, unfortunately, but this deck got me through. You are right, Reese. This deck is pretty sweet. Had more experience with the deck, I don't think I would have had such a hard time staying alive there, and so close to the brink of death. My land sequencing with this deck is not good so far. It's fine, but like, not up to par. So. Sweet. Removal, Pyromancer, Lingering Souls, bunch of value. Yeah. Let's play this and pass. Humans. Champion. Okay. Grab a Sacred Foundry. And bolt that. So I'll be Pyromancer. If I get an land here, I'm gonna go Lingering, but otherwise I'll go Faithless. Lingering seems solid, because if we can get Solemn later on, it's going to be devastating for them. Pyromancer, because I want to go Faithless next turn and get more tokens out of it. And we're most likely going to chump this champion, this elemental. We can Lingering Souls here. Get a couple blockers. Yeah, it seems like our best bet. Through this turn, but yeah, we can't keep up with that right now. So we go, I guess we can live one more turn, but I don't know what we're gonna draw here to keep ourselves in the game. The Ensnaring Bridge, the Lily. I think that's it. Spell Bombs are out. Collective does not seem great. They outscale it pretty quick. I like Blood Moon, but they can definitely get around it, but it's they can definitely just close them out of this game, so I think we're gonna keep it. I'm gonna trim one. I really don't wanna see more than one ever in this matchup. If we get it early, though, we can shut them out of the game if they don't have a Noble or a Vial. If they have either of those, we can definitely get them off the board. This scene seems pretty good. We got a lot of removal. Our Helix is kind of dead here, but we can draw into some quality cards. Kind of feel like just grabbing a Sacred Foundry right now and casting this Faith. Let's see what we can dig into. No lands, so we're gonna dip this Culligans and this Lingering Souls and pass it over. Lingering pass back. Mantis Riders and Reflector Mages if they're not casting anything. Bugler's solid too. I'm gonna draw another spell here. I mean, another land here. Doesn't make sense. Some of these other spells. I'm gonna push just to get rid of that bugler because of the trigger. Those are two cards. Be willing to settle for any land at this point, deck. Any land any land, so I can cast this Coligans, or cast that Faithless Looting in my graveyard, cast this Lingering Souls. Oh my gosh. Just so much value on their side. Cannot hit a land. Oh my gosh. I just needed to hit a land there. Oh my gosh, for so many turns. Alright, this hand's got a Pyromancer into Helix. No black, but we should be able to draw one here. And there's just one mana away from that Blood Moon, so. But knowing me, I'm never gonna draw it. Is this Grand Red? That's dead now. Why don't we drain them and take a card from them? Taking it out of the mix, and then we're going to we'll dreadboard that. Channels us on two here. Choosing not to, which is good. Swing. see if it would trigger the war boss. If we make the +1/+0 swing with our tokens, we'd have to chump with our pyromancer. So let's just run out a vampire and we'll pass a turn. I'm actually swing with the pyromancer because I don't think they'll block again. Get rid of these spell bombs, and we're gonna get rid of the blood moons because they're on the same exact game plan for that. I do want to bring in the timelies, the lilies, the Rakdos charms. The cabals don't seem bad. They don't seem great either. And Snare and Bridges, they're on the same game plan, so I'm hard pressed to bring those in. I think I'm just gonna bring in the one of Cabal and run it like this. Deck is pretty good. Our one loss was unfortunately just to a land draw so far, so. This. If they channel us on one, it'd be a little bit rougher, but if they don't. Okay. I'm gonna hold here and just pass it over. I'd like to be able to use that bolt in case they pyretic here to. Powerful three drop. Alright, they're gonna go for the chalice. One. It's gonna grab a sacred foundry. give up his rival master for a pyromancer. No, he will. Interesting. He must have another. War boss, similar. I'll take the 2. Hooligan's command right now would be great. This is good too. Why don't we helix away the war boss? Honestly, just aim to whittle us down with tokens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I think we're just gonna take it. Hope to draw a Solemn. True Sphere. Lingering Souls. Alright, we're dead here. Yeah, I think we're just gonna run it back. Alright, Thoughtseize turn 1 into a Dreadbore. Okay. Hazard's a little slow, but okay. Blood Moon, we do care about. Eidolon, we're fine with. Let's take the Blood Moon. We could just fetch up a Black Source. And then the only card that we're missing out on here is Lingering. So, yeah, why don't we do that? We'll take the Eidolon here. And then they won't be able to play anything for 2 turns. And then the most likely goal, Rabble Master. And then we can Dreadbore or Kulaginza. So. Even better. We draw an Inquisition. So we don't care about the Rival Master because we can kill it 2 different ways. Anger is fine because we have Hazard on, so we can get into that later. It kills tokens, that's fine too. So we're just going to take the Blood Moon here. That way we leave our mana open. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Thank you. fetching because I'm trying to increase our percentage of hitting a land, but again, we're most likely just gonna be grabbing a swamp with that, is what I'd like to do. Pass it back over to them because they're probably going to be playing the Rabble Master. And we can call against them, shoot it and take it down, and then try bore. Save the Culligans for the Rabble Master, so I don't really want to do anything right now. Because we can Dreadbore on our turn. Unless we wanted to Culligans right now and take out the Chalice and the Eidolon, but that Rabble Master is going to get out of control, so I think we should pass our turn. And we'll Dreadbore. Have to take three in the following turn. Hopefully we draw a land here. Just got anger in hand. We could collective brutality, take out the Rabble Master and take out the anger in their hand, discarding the lingering souls, both of them honestly, and try to gain some life because we're gonna lose a little. Next turn we take five. Go down quite a bit. Ugh. Yeah, I think that's our best option though. So we're gonna rip the card from them, kill the Rabble Master, and drain them. Discarding both lands. Pass it over. War boss. So we're going to take six, go down to four. Fatal Push and a Culligans and a Faithless. So I think we have to Faithless here to see if we can stay alive. Oh, it's gonna kill. I should have flashback Lingering Souls. And yeah, I'm just dead here. It didn't matter. If I wanted to cast two spells, I was dead because of the. But that was an accident. Yeah, Fatal Push was gone. The only option was Culligan's Command. Or flashing back lingering, and in either case I'm dead, so. Yeah, I think the priorities in that game of what I removed was just incorrect. That Eidolon was doing work. This seems super slow, and we're not doing anything. Oh, this sand seems miserable. I'm dead. I don't know. I'm keeping it because I think if we can get to the four, this hand's going to be solid, but we're just not doing anything for so long. If they have any kind of normal hand, we're just dead. We are a pro at this game. And we just draw what we need. I'm actually pretty excited for them to burn Aquarius. That's the next level tech. Just keep bad hands and our opponent will save us. Watch. Sure. Sure. Phoenix back, beat us for 7. Or, nope, these are our two times. Threes. Okay. Mars flats, pass it over, hold up helix. Flame-bladed up right now. That way... I think I know I can't return it. Get Hazard on my next turn, and then Solemn. And we'll grab a Plains here. Two lands in hand. And we can start racing. Lancer just in case we need to block the blood pass. Luckily for us, they have to attack. Okay. So another match where I'm not really impressed with Blood Moon here. I want to bring in the Rakdos. The Spell Bombs. The Ensnaring Bridges seem great. Card Disruption doesn't seem as a premium. Timely seem great. Cabal doesn't seem bad either, honestly. We'll run it like that. Removal spells and some Kolaghan seems good if they do drop their 4/4 artifact creatures. We'll run out of Bloodstain and just pass it here. I want to grab a Sacred Foundry, that way we can Dragon Skull Summit. And a Lightning Helix. Rough turn, I'll tell you what. See what's the bigger threat. Still gonna shoot this flame blade. Just chump the Gormog, take the 4, and then next turn try to go double block it into a Helix, see if that's good enough. Faithless possibly would get us the extra land. It'd be a gamble, but if we do that, we'll be able to Kolaghan's take out the Hollow One, and we're just in a rough spot either way then. But let's see if we can get there, because we really need to hit a land here. We did not. We can discard the Lingerings. And we'll flash it back. And try to light a turn. We can flashback Lingering Souls for two more blockers and try to Helix. We can Culligan's Command, blow up that. Every line seems very poor. This seems like the highest chance of staying alive. Blocking the Grimmog and the Hollow One. Helix. The Hollow One. No. Oh. That will brutality us. I think with that, we can only block that. We can eliminate one threat. Getting in. That's still going to be 8, 10, 12. Yeah, that's game. Let's try to run that back. Seems pretty solid. We should be able to stop them in their tracks if we can get this bridge out. Brutality, doing two modes. We want to neg it, and we're going to take a card from them, and we'll ditch our Helix. Goblin Lore, Faithless Looting. Let's get rid of the lore, and we'll pass it over to them. Oh my gosh, we need to land right now. We're so good at this. Thank you. Ensnaring Bridge. We'll start off with the Faithless Looting. Ditch the lingering in the swamp. I kind of want the redundant and staring just in case they didn't bring in removal, and then we'll just flash back our lingering souls and pass it over to them. I know they have a fatal push in hand and then one unknown. Thinking real hard. Taking this too. Fatal push left. We're gonna pass it over because we're gonna plan on lightning helixing that flame blade adept. Source, we can run out this reveler. So I think for now we're just gonna once again just swing. We're winning this race right now anyhow until they fatal push. Shoot that gas, they got a bloodstain there to bring it right back. I am going to shoot them though, because if we draw a source, I want to be able to just play a red source and drop this Bedlam Reveler. And if not, I want to be able to cast an Ensnaring Bridge. So. For us. does it use gamer timely activated?
So we can get some more creatures. If they go for the double block, we'll fatal push one. Oh wait, fatal push is there. They are 5/5s. They are 5/5s. That was bad. I mean, it wasn't terrible because I got rid of one other thing and they're still not swinging through, but their hollow one can now swing because we have four cards in hand. So we will we're still in a pretty strong spot. I actually want a double block here. If they play another creature, we can time them. Or just bring back their blood glass, we can time them. EE for three. Okay, there goes this bridge. But there goes their hollow one. Casting Street Raid, that's what's up. All Respect Faithless. Bend the Concealed. And the Fatal Push. We'll run out our Pyromancer. Hey, Epoch. Thanks for joining the end of the stream here. We played Vanifar Resto earlier, and we're currently playing Mardu Pyromancer. For sure. After this, I'll be logging off to finish my paper. I'll try to have the videos uploaded by tonight. The end of the night, but it probably won't be done processing until later into the morning. Yeah, we're solid one. Less creatures than them. So why don't we run out our timely, get three more dudes, hold up Fatal Push and Bolt. Oh, timely screwed us over because of Young Pyromancer. Okay. That's unfortunate. Either way, we're gonna swing. So it doesn't really matter. Because we're just, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just being rude to our opponent here, because they're dead, so. Like, definitely overthinking, because we've already won, and I'm doing nothing here but wasting their time. Okay, because we just had a bolt in hand, we could have just shot them. Okay. Oh, all right. Well, that's the end of the stream, obviously. I have